three, two, one.
Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon, and that is the SpaceX Starship prototype known as SN5. Now, if you're not familiar with the SpaceX Starship platform, this is SpaceX's next generation rocket that's intended to take people to the moon and to Mars. Right now, SpaceX is actively developing this platform, and they're doing this in an incremental fashion by building prototypes and then testing them. Now, I know this crazy grain silo looking thing doesn't really look like much of a rocket, but trust me, it is. And yesterday, on August 4th, it performed its first flight test up to an altitude of 150 meters or around 500 feet. Now, up on top of the Starship prototype is a mass simulator that helps bring up the center of mass higher on the vehicle to make it easier to control. And it does that by simulating the mass of what would be the nose cone up on top of the rocket, which obviously is not there right now. Inside the rocket, there are two fuel tanks, one for methane, the other one for liquid oxygen. And at the bottom of the rocket is a single Raptor engine along with the landing legs. Now, the engine along with the landing legs are actually tucked up inside the bottom of the rocket, inside the skirt. And that single Raptor engine, well, it's not actually in the center, it's slightly offset. And that's because eventually they intend for those engines to be in a cluster of three, and so there's no spot in the center to mount one. The flight test that was performed yesterday was a proof of concept designed to test to see whether they could launch it, control it, land it again. And here's what that looked like.
Three, two, one.
Now, it appears that most of the flight actually went really well. I mean, after all, it landed in one piece. But there were a few concerning things that had me checking my monitor a couple of times. One, right after launch, you can see all this debris over here on the side, along with a little extra flaminess here shortly after launch. Also, as the Starship was approaching landing, you can see a little extra flaminess here as well. This appears to be some sort of leak in the Raptor plumbing, although it obviously didn't have a major effect, but it makes you wonder, how long would this have lasted if the flight test wasn't nearly completed at this point? Now, it's important to remember that this is a test. It's development work, and these things are not meant to be perfect. This is a step in the right direction for SpaceX developing their Starship prototypes and will help lead them to future flights. This is one of the craziest things I've seen, but it was awesome. I can't wait till they launch it again. These are gonna be some exciting times, so stick around, because there's gonna be more. See you guys.